We'd like to thank the mothers who baked the cake for our class party.
Yay!
And now, what would you like to do?
Let's sing a song. No, let's say a poem. A real exciting one. The one about the band. Before the sound?
Is the musical trust?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, let's say it all together. Now, say when you're ready.
Let's go, Tommy.
Someone ought to sit over here. That's right.
There once was a man who could execute old Zip Coon on a yellow flute and several other tunes to boot. But he couldn't make a penny with his tune to shoot. One day he met a singular quaint old man with a big tuba who said, I have traveled wide and far, but I never made a penny with my oo-ha-ha. Then they met two men who were travelers with a big bass drum and a cymbal thing who said, we play since early spring, but we haven't made a penny with a boom thing thing. So the man with the flute went, and the other went, oom-ha, while the man with the drum and the cymbal thing went, boom, 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 sing, sing. And they traveled wide and far. Together they made the mountain ring with their oom-pa, boom, sing, sing. And all the pennies the people fling when they hear the oom-pa, oom-pa, sing, sing, sing.
You sound better at a party than you do at school. I suppose we should have parties more often. And now, does anybody have a poem he'd like to say by himself? A funny poem. Jimmy?
I never saw a purple cow. I'd never hope to see one. But I can tell you, here and now, I'd rather see than be one.
Yes, sir, I agree with you, Jimmy. But can someone give us a poem about something we can see?
Mr. Brown?
Tommy?
Well, I'd like to say a poem about something exciting.
All right, you go right ahead, fella.
A wet ship in the flowing sea, a wind that follows fast, and fills the white and rustling sail, and bends the gallant mast, and bends the gallant mast, my boy, while like the eagle free, away the good ship flies and leaves. Old England on the wing.
That's fine.
There's another verse.
Oh, fine. But look, when Tommy says the second verse, let's all try to think about the pictures he's talking about. Hmm? Go ahead, Tommy.
Oh, for a soft and gentle wind, I heard a fair one cry. But give to me the snoring breeze and white waves heaving high. And white waves heaving high, my lad, the good ship tight and free. A world of waters is our home, and merry men are we.
Oh, yeah.
Good enough, Tommy. That's wonderful. Now notice, the words in Tommy's poem made pictures. You can actually imagine you're seeing a picture. Now words make sounds, too. And sometimes they sound like real things. Wind, waves, or even a bus. And here's a poem I think you'll like. It's a story about a bus ride downtown. See if I can find it here. Oh, yes, here it is. Rumbling and rattly, good green bus. Where are you going to carry us? Up the shiny length of avenue, where lights keep company two by two.
where windows glitter with things to buy, and churches hold their steeples high. Round the circle and past the park, still and shadowy, dim and dark. Over the asphalt and into the drive, isn't it fun to be alive? Look to the left and the river's there, with ships and whistles and freshened air. To the right, more windows, row on row, and every one like a picture show, or little stages where people play at being themselves by night and day, and never guess that they have us for audience in the good green bus. And that's the poem about the bus. How'd you like it? It was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The words roll along just like a real bus, just like the ones we ride on downtown.
Mm-hmm. What else did you like about it?
I think it'll be more fun riding on a bus next time, because the poem tells you so many new things that you can look for.
You know, that's the best part about reading new poems. You start seeing old things in new ways, and that's always fun, isn't it?
Are poems written about everything, Mr. Brown?
Oh, just about everything. Let's see, we had poems about the wind and the waves, about a bus, and about Jimmy's cow. You know, anybody can write a poem, and he can write about whatever he pleases.
Can children write poems?
They certainly can. Here, I'll read you one. By a boy in the sixth grade. He liked trains, so he wrote about trains. Now, pretend now as I read this that you're actually seeing a train. Here comes the train, zooming along, taking its route each night and each day, singing a song as it swings and sways, so shiny, so gay, on its long, long way. Yes, here come the freight cars, so shiny and bright, zooming along till far out of sight. The whistle is tooting so jolly and gay. While people are watching, they smile and they say, there goes the train, so happy and gay, rumbling a song both night and day.
That was fun. Mr. Brown, could we write a poem like this? Can we all write a poem?
Certainly. What would you like to write about?
Something just for fun.
Just for fun. Say, that reminds me. Marshmallows.
Oh, wait a minute.
Toast them in the fireplace. We'll take turns using the forks. And those of you who are not using forks, I'd appreciate it if you'd start cleaning up the tables, will you?
Sure. We can write a poem about toasting marshmallows. But how do we start?
Well, supposing we just start by, just thinking of a line. How does it feel to toast marshmallows?
Warm.
Warm, that's a good start. What else?
I thought of a whole poem. Marshmallows are good toasted unless you get your fingers roasted.
How true.
How's this? Their forks are very long and straight.
That's a good line. Anyone else?
Our hands and faces are warm.
Good. Fine. Anyone else?
We rest our forks across the grate until the crust is brown. But that doesn't rhyme. Poems have to rhyme, don't they, Mr. Brown?
Well, no, they don't, Lynn. As a matter of fact, we've already written a poem.
We have?
We certainly have. Listen to this. Our forks are long and very straight. Our hands and faces are warm. We rest our forks across the grate until the crust is brown. How do you like it?
Good.
Poems are fun, to read and to write. My class has a party only once a year. But we say poems, and we write poems all the year round. Would your class like to write a poem? You know, poems are fun.